A while back I posted this video on how to make this end table piece of furniture, and I mentioned that I put stainless steel adjustable feet on here. At the time I didn't tell you how to do that, so this is the detail on how to set up that job. This is not a welding video per se. I assume you already know how to do welding and you don't want another video on some trivial thing like that, but I'll show you how to set this up a couple different ways and how to weld these adjustable stainless feet on there. So the parts we need is just a bolt and a nut like that. Doesn't have to be a stainless nut, but I do use stainless because I got them. And that's it, just a carriage bolt. And also, I'm going to use this to show how we're going to do this. It's just a small piece of this metal I cut off, and it'll make it easier to show on camera how this is done. So what we want to do is we want to get that nut inside the square tubing and get it welded in there. If you try to do it this way, you'll probably mess up the threads. And there's another trick to this, that if you try to do it this way and you say, oh, I'll just take the bolt out of there, then what will happen is there's a really good chance you'll get in there cockeyed like this, and when you try to put the bolt in there, it will bind up against the sides. So let me show you how I prep this and get it in there so you can weld it in there so it'll be relatively straight and the screw will come in and out without binding. So what you want to do is you want to take your square tube and take a thin cutting wheel and make cuts across here this way and this way, make a cross on it. I've done that on the other end. And this is where we're going to weld. It's not beautiful, but it will work. We're going to put our screw in here, our nut in here, and we'll have two flats. We'll have a flat, a point, a flat, and a point to be welding on. This is where we're going to do our welding. And you will want to put the bolt all the way in when you weld it so that you'll be ensured that even if it is not exactly lined up, that it won't bind when you put it all the way in. You can do something like put masking tape around the top of this, make a, you know, some masking tape around here to hold it centered. I don't do that myself, but you can. And on this, if you want this screw not to come out, you can also put some welding up here on this end of the screw to prevent it from backing out. Again, that's not something I do, but you can. Okay, so we'll have the bolt up inside here. Needless to say, we won't be able to see this because the leg continues on and it will hide that, so you'll see that. And then what you'll do is you'll just weld this. You'll do a good weld here and here and here and here, and then any grinding you need to finish it up. And that's that for this style. And when you're done, it will look like, it'll look like this. So what happens if you're welding to larger stock or a round stock or something like that where the bolt won't fit in there nicely? Well, the answer is pretty easy. You start out with a washer like this, and you're going to weld the nut to the washer. And yeah, it's a little bit tricky because you got to get a good weld down inside there. And then you're just going to take this washer and you're going to weld it onto the bottom of your round stock. And I will show you an example of where I've done that. In the background you can see a stand I made. Here's the foot off of its sister part. And it's just the same type of thing. I've got a carriage bolt and it's welded to, the nut has been welded to a washer, you can see here. And then the washer was welded onto the tube stock. And that's pretty much it. And it makes an adjustable leg for my hydroponic garden stand. Well, that's it. I hope you found it useful and interesting.